Friday, November 18th, here at the First Pilgrims Baptist Church, 1228 Arch Street, here in the Bywater area of New Orleans. We will be here with national recording artist, Pastor John P. Key.
I decided to take a stand, not believing, at least some of my friends. And I would rather, I'd rather live right, than in hell, lift up my eyes.
Doors open at 9 a.m. The concert starts at 10 a.m. right here at First Pilgrims Baptist Church, 1228 Arch Street in New Orleans. And we'll be here with national recording artist, live, Pastor John P. Key. We hope to see you here. The concert is absolutely free. Looking to see you.
Good morning. Good morning. This is Pastor Mitchell. Thank you for tuning in to this morning's telecast. I hope that it be a blessing to you and that you receive a message from the message. Don't forget, you could come and visit us every Sunday morning, 7:45 and 11 a.m. You could also tune in and listen to us on WYLD, Wild for Jesus, Monday through Friday at 12 o'clock noon. We're located at 1228 Arch Street, New Orleans, Louisiana. Now let us go into this morning's telecast.
Beginning at the first verse. And they came over unto the other side of the sea into the country of the Gadarenes. And when Jesus was come out of the ship, immediately there met him out of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit. Let's go down to the 18th verse. And when he was come into the ship, he that had been possessed with the devil prayed him that he might be with him. However, Jesus suffered him not, but said unto him, go home to thy friends and tell them how great things the Lord had done for you and had compassion on you. And he departed and began to publish in Decapolis how great things Jesus had done for him, and all men did marvel. Verse number 2, and when he was come out of the ship, immediately there met him of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit, 3rd verse, who had his dwellings amongst the tombs, and no man could bind him, no, not with chains. I want to talk about a spiritual disconnect. Amen. A spiritual disconnect. Now we don't know what really happened to this man whom the Bible refers to as Legion. But we do know he had a legion of demons. I've seen folk just have one and act a plum fool. But this man was controlled by a legion of demons. Evidently, he was disconnected from Jesus. Not only that, but because there was no relationship with Jesus, there was a disconnect from society. This man had issues. He had problems. Matter of fact, anytime you live in a graveyard, something wrong upstairs. You might say he was a couple of eggs short of a dozen. You might say his elevator didn't go to the top. Somebody might say he was thrown or just strode off. There were no lights upstairs. But I see a disconnect. And anybody that don't have Jesus, there's a disconnect. Anybody that don't have Christ in their lives, there are some things going on that if it's not causing you a problem now, it will cause you one after a while. This man lived in the cemetery. I don't know what drove him to that. The Bible doesn't say how we got there. And one that doesn't have Christ, you'll find yourself in some jacked up places, some jacked up situations. I don't know how you make it, but I got to have Jesus. And I always tell you, it's good to have him and not need him than to need him and not have him. This man lived in a cemetery. He lived among dead folk. He lived with dead folk. There was something wrong with that. It's not natural. I could understand you living under the bridge. I could understand you living in City Park. I could understand you're homeless, but living in a cemetery, living with dead folk. Jesus said the living can't what? Live amongst the dead. The dead can't live amongst the living. This man had issues. He had problems, y'all, but I don't know what drove him, but I know whenever a man don't have Christ, he'll have some crises in his life. But see, I got Christ, and whenever I got a crisis, I've got Christ. And how many know Christ worked in all crises? He is the answer to any problem that you can have. This man known as Legion, y'all, I don't know if he went through a divorce, because some folks have lost their minds over a divorce. Let me tell you, you're not validated by your ex-wife. Oh, no, I'm not validated by my wife, because I was somebody before I met her, and if I got to go on without her, as long as I got Jesus, as long as I'm connected to Jesus, as long as I'm in Christ, I could make it through any crisis. I could make it through any situation. As long as I got Jesus, as long as she got Jesus, if I died and go to heaven, she's got to go on. But I've seen folk get heart attacks and stressed out over somebody leaving them. I've seen folk lose a job, stop coming to church, got disconnected. Well, let me tell you, can't nothing disconnect me from Jesus. I don't care how rough it gets. I don't care how dark it gets. I don't care how sick I get. I'm connected. Because I know if I mess around, it's dangerous to get disconnected. If you get disconnected, even from the fellowship, Because you could be in Christ, you could be connected, but disconnected from the fellowship. And you know this thing today, you don't have to go to church or you don't have to go to the house, or you could just have a relationship and you could stay at home. The Bible said, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together. Jesus went to the temple. And we need fellowship with each other. Bible said, iron sharpens iron. I need to be connected to some strong folk. If it's just a few hours on Sunday, I need to be connected with some strong folk. I'm connected to Jesus. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things. I'm connected, but I need to be connected to the fellowship. A lot of folk have become disconnected because they don't have a prayer life. You may not end up sleeping with the dead in the tombs, but let me tell you, you'll find yourself getting weak. You got to have a prayer life. Salvation is having a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, but in a relationship, there ought to be some fellowship. Don't tell me you don't go to church. Don't tell me you're not a part of a fellowship. You need fellowship. Some folk have become disconnected because of trials and tribulations, because of dark times in their lives. I mean, know all of us gonna have some trouble in our lives. I don't care who you are, you're gonna have some trouble. Everything ain't gonna always go right in your life. Jesus told me to tell you, in this world you shall have tribulation, but here's your consolation: in your tribulation, in me, you shall find peace. It's dangerous to be disconnected. Disconnect, right there. Disconnect simply means to break the connection. Of a between. Disconnect, unhook, unhitched, undo, unfasten, unyoked. That's spiritual. Unyoked, separated, cut off, divorce, sever, removed. Whole lot of y'all have removed yourself from the fellowship. Well, a whole lot of folk have removed themselves. And you'll find yourself in a mess. You may not be in a literal cemetery, in a literal tomb, but you'll still be among the dead. Oh, yeah, you'll start hanging with dead folk. Yeah, you could have a heartbeat and still be. Oh, yeah, you could be breathing, but yet dead. Matter of fact, there are some saints on life support. I'm trying to help somebody. You got a heartbeat, but you're weak. You need help to help you. You can live with dead folk. Some of y'all got a dead husband. Dead children. I'm talking about spiritually dead now. That means they don't know Christ. They are spiritually dead. And that's why when folk come to church who really don't know Jesus, we could be praising and shouting and running and talking in tongues and dancing, and they just sit there. Looking at us like we're crazy. But the problem is there's dead among the living. We're alive. And alive means active. Alive means that movement. Alive means we got a spiritual heartbeat. But when they go to the clubs, that same person with the same instrument in a nightclub, that same person could get up and juke and jump and buck and come on, talk to me. But when they get in the house of the Lord, because alive folk, the Bible said, let everything that had breath praise ye the Lord. move. I got life. I got to move. I got spiritual life. When I hear somebody say hallelujah, I got to say yes, Lord. When somebody say the Lord is good, I got to say I know him. When somebody say the Lord is blessing me, I got to say yes, Lord, hallelujah. Because I could be dead and sleeping in my grave. I could be lost and sleeping under the bridge somewhere. I could have been sleeping in a grave, y'all. I could have been the one slit my wrist. But the Lord. I don't know why. I can't judge him. He was messed up, y'all. But the good news is, Jesus showed up. How many of us was messed up until Jesus showed up in our life? Some of y'all were no good. Some of y'all were so low down till you were low down. Some of us were so bad that we were bad, but Jesus showed up. Now I always remind myself, if it wasn't for his grace, I'd still be a disgrace. Jesus comes on a ship in the first verse into the country of the Gadarenes. And when he was come out the ship, Jesus steps out the ship. Immediately there met him out of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit. Unclean spirits are demons. Immediately. Right away, as Jesus step off the ship, here come the devil. Unclean spirits are demons. Yeah, this man had a legion of demons. But then when he saw Jesus, he ran toward Jesus. And you know what that tells me? There was something in this man that really wanted help. That's why you gotta be careful about judging crazy folk, judging folk who are going through some stuff, because deep down in their soul, they really wanna do the right thing, but they're too weak. He could have ran the opposite direction from where Jesus was. Bible says, watch this third verse, who had his dwellings among the tombs. He lived in a graveyard. I don't know how he got there. I don't know what put him there, what drove him there, but that's where he was. It is what he is, and he is where he is. And watch this. No man could bind him. No, not with chains. They tried to arrest him. They tried to chain him, but he was so strong, so full of demons, he would pop. He would break the shackles. He would break the chains. And the devil can give you some supernatural strength. That's why it's bad to fool with crazy folk. Oh, yeah, they've got demons. And you better be careful. Laughing at that woman, bro, that woman will beat you down. I've seen them in action. Folk who are possessed. He was possessed, y'all. He lost his mind. You can't make me believe anybody that sleep in a cemetery night after night and day after day in their right mind. He was crazy. He was insane. Watch this. Bible said, third verse, who had his dwelling among the tomb, and no man could bind him. They couldn't tie him up. He'll break the ropes. He'll break the shackle. No man could chain him. Why? Fourth verse said, because he had been often bound with fetters and chain, and had plucked them asunder. And the fetters broken them in pieces. Neither could any man tame him. Nobody could control him. Man, legion was messed up. Oh, yeah, they couldn't control him. They couldn't tame him. And not only that, did he have all these demons. He had violent demons, but he had a suicidal demon. Yeah, the Bible says, fifth verse, and always night and day, he was in the mountain and in the tomb, he was crying and cutting himself with stones. Getting stones and just cutting himself. Running barefooted on top of stones and sharp stones, cutting up his feet. He had issues. He had problems. And the problem was he was disconnected. And when you disconnect, you're going to always have problems. Yeah, he was spiritually disconnected, and that caused him to have mental problems, emotional problems. The good news is he met Jesus. Yeah, sixth verse says, watch this, but when he saw Jesus, he saw Jesus afar off. He was a distant, but he saw Jesus. And you know what? He ran, y'all. He ran. He made sure he didn't miss an opportunity to worship Jesus. It's in the text. He wanted to be connected. Yeah, he wanted to be connected, y'all. He knew he was disconnected. There was something in him told him that wasn't natural. There was something in him told him that wasn't right. There was something in him that told him that he's crazy. Connect me to be joined, to be linked to be united with, to be bound, to fasten together. He wanted to be connected. And I don't know how folk could be spiritually disconnected. In other words, don't have Christ in your life. I don't know how folk make it. But this afternoon, I need to tell you, you need to be connected. Yeah, you're not there yet, but keep on living. You need a relationship with Jesus. You need to have Christ in your life. Because there's coming some days in your life where you're going to need Jesus. I'm glad I got Jesus. This man saw Jesus. And the Bible said he ran, y'all. And he began to worship him. In other words, there was something in him that wanted change. There was something in him that wanted a relationship with Jesus Christ. Watch this, the Bible says in the seventh verse, he worshiped and then he said, what have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou son of the most high God? Now he knew he was the son of the most high God. But there was something in him, and that was those demons that didn't want him to have that reconnection. There was something in him that was trying to keep him from joining Christ. So those demons said, what do we have to do with you, Jesus? Thou son of the most high God. Those demons cried out and said, do you come to torment us before our time? But ain't you glad that Jesus got all power? And I don't care if you disconnect today. Can I tell you he's able to reconnect you?
Thank you once again for tuning in on this morning. I'm sure that it has been a blessing to you on this morning. I also invite you to come out on every Sunday morning, 7:45 and 11 a.m. We're located at 1228 Art Street, New Orleans, Louisiana. You could also listen to us on WYOD, Wild for Jesus, Monday through Friday at 12 o'clock noon. God bless you, and I hope to see you on next week.
If you'd like a copy of today's message on audio CD, call area code 504-944-0504 or stop by the administrative office of First Pilgrims Baptist Church, 1228 Arch Street in New Orleans. Please have the name of today's message for better efficiency.
Friday, November 18th, here at the First Pilgrims Baptist Church, 1228 Arch Street, here in the Bywater area of New Orleans. We will be here with national recording artist, Pastor John P. Key.
I decided to take a stand, not believing I'd lose some of my friends. And I would rather, I'd rather live right, learn in hell, lift up my eyes. All of our children just stand, stand. Everybody saying you stand. Oh, stand for holiness.
Stand for holiness.
Oh, stand for holiness,
stand for holiness, stand for righteousness.
And be counted among them. Oh, oh, stand.
Stand.
And believe. Believe. Shall receive his own. People say, come out.
Doors open at 9 a.m. The concert starts at 10 a.m. right here at First Pilgrims Baptist Church, 1228 Arch Street in New Orleans. And we'll be here with national recording artist, live, Pastor John P. Key. We hope to see you here. The concert is absolutely free. Looking to see you.